In fulfillment of the constitutional requirement under Article 101, Clause 1 of the Constitution of the Republic of Uganda, the President will deliver the State of the National Address tomorrow. The event, which also opens the new year of Parliament, has been organized at Kololo Independence Grounds.
But definitely, I expect him to talk on his favorite subject about household incomes. How do you create wealth? He cannot miss that. He cannot miss mentioning the flagship projects of government, that is the Emyoga and the parish development model.
Taking a snapshot into the event, members of parliament have asked the president to address the future of Uganda's economy as development partners threaten to pull out following the enactment of the Anti-Homosexuality Act 2023.
Tell Ugandans the tentative measures that the government has got to ensure that the economy stabilizes. Because as I talk now, the economy is shrinking, people don't have money, people have what to sell, but those to buy don't have money to buy. So there's a very big problem.
Therefore, we need to address the issue of ensuring that people have money so that they can steer the economy. Because if money is in the hands of a very few people, definitely, even if we come up with good programs, we are going to hit a snag, because not many people are going to be having the money. It therefore means we shall affect the chain of production.
The Elgon North legislator, Gerald Nangoli, has urged the president to speak out on the ever-increasing domestic arrears which the government owes suppliers.
They are demanding government a lot of money, trillions of shillings. They expect to hear from His Excellency the President. How are they going to be paid? Because as I talk now, they have mortgaged their properties, and they expect government to come up with a permanent solution for that.
The State of the Nation address comes at the height of insecurity characterized by gun violence, which has claimed scores of lives. Legislators now want the president to spend a better part of his speech to provide solutions for gun violence.
I want the president to address the issue of criminality, especially the escalation of gun-wielding people who go around shooting themselves and colleagues.
To address the country as far as the security issues are concerned, what confidence can he give us that now Ugandans can be safe? They are no longer going to be attacked. They are no longer going to be targeted the way they have been killed.
So I think the president needs to really look into the issues of the security forces. If it is the salaries, if it's the welfare, we need to address the issues in the budget so that their issues are looked at seriously, because these are also Ugandans who have families, they have children who want to go to good schools just like another Ugandan.
MPs also want the president to give a full accountability of Uganda's mission in Somalia, which claimed lives of 54 UPDF soldiers, and a way forward.
To brief Ugandans about what happened in Somalia, how many people have died, what was the cause, what happened exactly, and the way forward, so that this should not occur.
Our forces are supposed to move out of Somalia and come back to provide security here. But we also need assurance about their welfare when they come back.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.